If the squad ain't with me, then it ain't right. Yeah. Hey. Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. Yeah.
PPP love. Ay. Time to bring the bass.
Yeah. Hey. 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 Same squad. Same squad. Same squad. Drop top coupe, Dodge raindrops. Big back plays on FaceTime. Squad ain't with me, then it ain't right. Same squad. Same squad. Same squad. Big back plays on FaceTime. Squad ain't with me, then it ain't right. Same squad, same squad, same squad. Cross move quick like AI. Chain shine bright like daytime. Stack big bread like waist high. I don't do lanes. Lil' watch y'all like 2 Chainz. I done swerved in a new lane. Bang at the grit, do things. I came up, who I was down with. You change up, stay far from around me. I came up, who I was down with. You change up, stay far from around me. Same squad, same squad, same squad. Drop top, coupe, Dodge raindrops. Big back plays on FaceTime. Squad ain't with me, then it ain't right. Same squad, same squad, same squad. Drop top, coupe, Dodge raindrops. Big back plays on FaceTime. Squad ain't with me, then it ain't right. Yeah, no it ain't, no it they ain't talking cash, so I did the race. NASCAR with the pace, Fiji water on the chain. You know love where I'm from. When I'm on the beat, I make it thump. I need that bread like every crumb. Came up from nothing, made a sum. I came up, who I was down with. You change up, stay far from around me. I came up, who I was down with. You change up, stay far from around me. Same squad, same squad, same squad. Top coupe, Dodge raindrops. Big back plays on FaceTime. Squad ain't with me, then it ain't right. Same squad, same squad, same squad. Drop top coupe, Dodge raindrops. Big back plays on FaceTime. Squad ain't with me, then it ain't right. Ay, 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 ay.
It's one of them ones, man. You just in the car, man. It's like when you in the car, you just think about everything, man. Definitely when you like you by yourself and you just cruising on the highway, man. Yeah, this got me thinking. On that cap, swerving through traffic, listening to trap. My windows ain't tinted, so notice me. Four braids, Yankee fitted, yeah, know it's me. I'm everywhere comfortable, but I'm still attentive. A young with money will make offended. I ain't flashy, I'm classy, but I ain't stupid either. Never show up to that's hungry and eager. My brother's keeper, I'm loyal, it's all in my demeanor. A true believer, I believe when they didn't believe her. That's why I don't let opinions affect me. I do what I wanna do. If they do or they don't accept me, they expect me to give up. I almost did. Things went from moving fast to slow motion. I was losing focus, stuck on that. It was smooth on the surface, but underneath it was broken. Hoping to find hope in this hopeless world we live in. What you give is what you given. Gotta make wise decisions, gotta stay tunnel vision. Gotta avoid collision, keep scratching the surface and keep your palms itching. Gotta pay moms a visit, it's been a while. I've been working, she keep telling me she miss her child. I find myself passing the house, then I spin around. She say I'm always moving, ma, I just can't sit around. Oh my, cause the cash ain't gon' come to us. When we was down, who gave a dime or gave a f for us? So instead of making it hard, I made it fun for us. Make it easy, so when you need it, you just run to us. But it's a lot of pressure, I'm trying to stick and move through this. Fixing these bumps on the road so I can just cruise through this. Living my life on the road, I'm trying to get used to this. And when they throw dirt, I just act like a broom to this. Trying to stay true to this. Even when they lie on me, world on my shoulders, my girl can't even cry on me. God watching over me, the devil probably spy on me. I've been going through some, Kenneth keep an eye on me. I know it's been a drought, but to my fans, don't go dry on me. If you want a picture, take a picture, don't get shy on me. I'm here to inspire, I admire that you admire me. I've been in the dark, but I promise you'll see a bite of me. I'm sorry. To all my supporters, man, I love y'all. I just want to say thank you for
been supporting me since day one. You don't want to see me win, man. I don't know why, but we gonna win anyway. I came straight out the with a microphone. Boy, I swear I couldn't leave that mic alone. Everybody clear the room, I like to write alone. I'm in my zone, bass bouncing off the styrofoam. I'm never in between, I'm either hot or cold. Can't be a loser, I maneuver like I got a clone. I'm out here in these streets like I ain't got a home. And you barely hear from me like I ain't got a phone. Because there's no days off, there's no days off. I know it sounds a little painful, but it pays off. Social sites was distracting, so I stayed off. Spoke to God, then me and Satan had a face-off. I swear my life was like a rocket, then it takes off. First I plotted, then I got it, couldn't wait long. I put the pedal to the metal, then took the brakes off. And I kept it A1 like the steak sauce. My paychecks used to be a pair of Jordans, and I know I can't afford them, but I went ahead and bought them. Then I quit, started, spent my money on recording. Yeah, the studio was small, but man, that made me a fortune. Made me a fortune, man. Trying to stop me. Y'all can't stop me. This is forever. Forever, man. I mean that.
Look at the cash coming in. Come get your man slim from the bugging me. Just need a bag, quit out of jaw jackery. Don't even be that, I don't want none of it. He's mad about it, had enough of it. Whoa, watch what you saying, how that popping and shaking. Got me as a laser, my posse deep and irate. We act a fool for the paper, had a dream and I made it. El Camino on Dayton's, bitches guess over bait. Put the brand on me. I'ma bake it, big it flat in the blanket. I might just roll out today. I might just roll out to Vegas, head back to my old ways. Cop a roof and hit for all day. Look at me, baby. Look at me, baby. Don't I look like a million? I'm about to clean out the safe. Don't I look like somebody that just be bodying and everything? All that talking is great, but I don't be talking. I air it out. All the problems have gotten easy to bury. I'd rather kiss on my. I've been broke for way longer than I've been rich, so until it levels out, I'ma take mama to the Marriott. Took me so long to get it, gonna spread it out. Let them know all about me when I'm dead and gone. One in the hand, one in the bag of them. One in the hand, one in the bag of them. Look at the cash, look at the cash bubbling. Look at the cash bubbling. One in the hand, one in the hand. One in the hand, one in the bag, bubba. Look at the cash, look at the cash, bubba. Look at the cash, bubba. I'ma need all the fries you can give me. All the hot sauce, all the pie you can give me. Better be all or nothing, don't have me in the middle. You better be all you can, yeah, yeah, yeah. Super fly for the Dumbos. Plenty slides like a shuffle. Hit the cadence on my young girl. Isaac Hayes, Billy Ocean. About the old with the cane stick. Let my slippers at the function. It's hard to run the Gucci slides. That bet you say you didn't have a. I'ma stay up. No, Jackie Chan, no travel. Can't clean it with the beans. Dripping from the. No, no, not me. I can never be the one you want to stuff for. Money, money, that machine. The bell got my stove. RIP the times that I was broke. Acting like a 9/11, folks. Matt back, liquor clean. And I'm a local, cooking up canard, waiting for the antidote, running out of time, patience thinner than a penny, ho.
Bro, you're gonna empty your pockets. I don't do that.
In my prison, you do what I tell you. Get over.
He's gonna get there.
From a city that's played host to 10 Super Bowls, here's a look inside the Mercedes-Benz Superdome in New Orleans. Coming up, an important divisional round matchup in the NFC between the Atlanta Falcons and the New Orleans Saints. One of two spots in the NFC title game awaits the winner here as we're underway in the divisional round of the NFL playoffs. That'll be taken in the end zone. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. First down, Bridgewater. And quick throw here, that's complete. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Now that's often a surprise for the defensive guys when they see the big fella slide out of the backfield and catch the ball. Not something they usually go over in practice very often.
So second and inches after that first down completion went just shy of the marker. And they'll run it here. Only a gain of a yard there, but it indeed gets them a new set of downs.
Second and inches is oftentimes an invitation for an offense coordinator to take a big shot downfield because he feels like he can come back on third down and pick up the first down. But sometimes you just don't want to break tendency. Stay with what you are, stay with who you know, and go get the first down. That's exactly what they did.
And that's off the mark, incomplete. Cameron Meredith, the intended target, and that'll bring up second down.
Let's face it, you can run the route tree as many times as you want, get in sync, practice it, do all those things. But once you get to game speed, it doesn't always time up quite that well. That one goes incomplete.
Here now is second and 10, again from the 41. A second down throw for Bridgewater. Pressure brought in, and the Falcons get there for the sack. Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football. Before he knew it, he was on his back.
So that just brings us right back to what you said in the beginning. A great job defensively. Nowhere to go with the football. That led to the sack.
Third and long now after the sack, and we'll see if Bridgewater has a response. Out of the gun, Bridgewater. And this is going to be incomplete.
Well, we quit counting yardage on that one, didn't we? That was truly third and a mile, wasn't it?
It was. I thought they might just go underneath, but they didn't. They wanted to get the first down there.
Yeah, they tried to pick up the huge chunk unsuccessfully. I'm with you. I would have tried to take some yardage just to gain some field position.
Here's Thomas Morstead on now to punt it away on fourth down. This is taken at the 18. So a change of possession here on the punt, and the Falcons will be taking over first and 10. The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. They'll run for the first time with Devontae Freeman. Solid move, but he's corralled just beyond the 40. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards, and it's second and 2. On second down, here's Ryan. And finding the tight end, Hooper. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. Call it a gain of 7, and it gets him a new set of downs. This is Freeman on first and 10. And he's going to take this one down inside the 45. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and 3.
A nice run here early on. It doesn't take a great play caller to realize you want to establish a guy of his caliber with runs like this early, because they will pay dividends as the game progresses.
On second down, Freeman. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. Give him 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn him a fresh set of downs. Couple of nice carries back-to-back here, establishing the ground game a bit.
Yeah, these aren't bare-bones runs now. I mean, they're getting substantial yardage, the kind of yards you're looking for, right? Let's go ahead and use a cliche. Stay ahead of the change, right? Five or more yards each time. That's what you're looking for in setting a tone and getting your offensive line going.
Good sign on the opening drive. And he'll get it down inside the 30 to the 29-yard line. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down. Throw it with Ryan. Oh, he stays up, but now he's swallowed up and taken down. Cameron Jordan in there to get him for a loss of 5. And we say it all the time, have to be able to get rid of the ball sooner than that.
You have to help your offensive line out. They're going to protect you as best they can. And if you're getting 3 to 5 seconds to throw the ball, they're doing a really nice job. But when you hold it and give up a sack, you're really almost discrediting their work.
On third down, Ryan. This one complete to Mohamed Sanu. Just one catch for him last week in the wild card win, but getting involved early here and picks up the first. Nice job keeping that opening drive alive, and they're in plus territory, that part of the field where you really want to convert on third down. They did.
Big time pickup for them, and now I think the aggressive play callers think to themselves, this part of the field, I take my shot at the end zone, because the closer you get to the end zone, the field gets condensed. Makes it a lot tougher to run those routes. You still got a chance to actually run past people right now. Take your shot at the end zone early in the down and distance count.
Ryan going to give to Freeman on the draw. And not much. Maybe a yard down to the 23.
Well, it didn't appear to be a run blitz. He just darted in once he saw the run develop. That appeared to be a case of see ball, get ball.
And on third down, a nickel formation 21. Here defensively.
21. 21. Hey,
Ryan. And he's got a man, Calvin Ridley. In the wild card win last week, he had just 2 catches, and now he's got his first one here.
But we always hear about the connections some quarterbacks have with certain receivers. I think this guy has a connection with just about everyone. Didn't mind throwing it in there against double coverage to him.
Show some confidence, supreme confidence.
Big time confidence that he would make the play for it, and he did.
And a pickup of about 4 down inside the 10 to the 8-yard line.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice game like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now, because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. Devontae Freeman, an 8-yard touchdown run. And the Falcons are in for 6. I think that's the dream start right there. The defense stands up on the opening drive, then they go right down the field and score.
It's a positive start for your offense and your defense. And when you're talking about playoff football, what a great way to get things going.
Everything is magnified and amped up a little bit more.
To put it mildly.
Here's Bosher to kick it away. That's fielded in the end zone. He juked it. And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been, and he simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. Out onto the field comes New Orleans, and hoping to do better than they did their last possession when they punted the football.
Appeal to the vanity of your offensive line. Tell them that they control your fate. Leverage guys. Win the line of scrimmage. If you do that, you start to win first down. You win second down. And guess what? You start accumulating first downs. And that's what they need in order to not punt the ball again.
And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Nice way to start the drive. A gain of 12 and a first down. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Bridgewater now looking to throw on first. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back. Complete. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. First down throw for Bridgewater. He's going to wind up and air it out. Got a man. It's caught inside the 10. It's a big play there for the Saints. 42 yards. A first opportunity upcoming in the red zone for the Saints. They're looking at a first and goal from about the 9.
Delta.
They'll throw again. Bridgewater. That's complete right around the 8. And he's able to get this down to the 5-yard line before he's out of bounds. That'll bring up second and goal after the gain of 5.
I think it's okay there. They didn't get a whole lot on that play, but it's nice to have a safety valve that's built like this guy. Big target, guy you can spot pretty easily. Put it on him when your other targets aren't open.
And the ball smack dab on the 5-yard line. Here's second and goal. And again, it's Bridgewater. Flush to his right. And they're going to get to him. A sack. Sack back at the 9-yard line. A minute 59 to go in the first half. Back with more NFC playoff action after this. Third and goal for Bridgewater. And that is, I think he caught it. He did, but they'll say out of bounds. It'll be incomplete. The third down battle won by Atlanta's defense. Solid coverage. And Lutz's kick is good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. That drive took him inside the 10. Good job defensively to hold him to 3.
Yeah, I like how you did that. Give a little tip of the cap to the stop troops there because they didn't give up a touchdown in that situation, right? Made him kick the field goal. And
a big seam, and he might go all the way. 30, 10, touchdown, Falcons. Ito Smith, 104 yards. And the Falcons will extend their lead. Extra point up and good by Tavecchio. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. So let's try this again. After the kick return TD, here's yet another kickoff. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he nearly broke that for more. But as it is, they'll start this drive at about the 37-yard line. Out is the Saints offense now as they get ready to take over here. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy. And the Falcons get there. The Falcons get the sack. Down he goes. Vic Beasley. He's the one that got to him. He takes him down for a loss of 9. Sacks a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long. From the shotgun, it's Bridgewater. And the pressure gets to him again. Grady Jarrett in there to get him. And this pass rush strong now. That sack's on back-to-back plays. Third and long now after the sack. And we'll see if Bridgewater has a response. From the gun, Bridgewater. He'll air it out deep for Thomas. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Keanu Neal. Thomas, the intended target.
Well, Brad, Brendan, there's no question who they're going to look to on third and long, but you can bet this defense knows that as well, so they've got him blanketed downfield. And this ball winds up being intercepted.
Now contact up front as penalty markers come in. Who is this against? So a jump there defensively.
It's a killer. Watch the football. Don't move across the line of scrimmage until the ball moves.
A boost here to start the drive. After the penalty, it's first and five. Now Ryan. He sets to fire deep. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Marcus Williams. And he's able to get it back to the 33-yard line.
Partner, when you're playing cover two, this is like a tag team for the safeties. Each of them gets a half-field responsibility. Their job, stay as deep as the deepest receiver in any zone, read the football, and go make a play. In this case, the free safety made the best play, an interception.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Here's Bridgewater. He gets this one complete to Traquan Smith. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead, as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. This quarterback now, 6 of 10 in this first half. He's got his guys a first down here. Bridgewater. And down he goes. The pressure getting to Bridgewater. And before the second down play, we'll get a whistle, a signal, and a timeout, as they'll stop the clock with 26 seconds to go until halftime. Sacks, a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long. Here's Bridgewater. He's going to sling this deep downfield. It's caught inside the 25. Touchdown, New Orleans. A big play there as the first half is winding down. And the Saints have cut it back within a score. Well, this could be a big turnaround. They get the touchdown here in the final moments of the second quarter. And remember, Charles, they're going to get the ball to start quarter number three as well.
So what you're saying is if they take the ball down to start the second half and score again, it could change the entire complexion of this game, couldn't it?
Absolutely. Lutz with the extra point. And that makes it a 14-10 ball game. Morstead, the punter, out to kick it off. This is taken at his four. And a good effort on the return there. Gets him across the 30 to the 33-yard line. Here are the Falcons as their offense heads back onto the field. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. And the Saints' pressure gets him. Brought down for a sack. So we've come upon halftime here in this NFC divisional round matchup, as we send you on over to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman in our EA Sports halftime report. Take it away, Coach. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. A trip to the NFC title game hanging in the balance. Second half action back underway. That's fielded in the end zone. And good starting field position. He'll get this one all the way up to about the 35-yard line. And here now come the Falcons. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the third quarter.
I like the way you term that, because
Now I think they go a little bit deeper into their playbook. They like what they did in the first half. That worked okay. But in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change things up a little bit. Change your tendencies. Try and hit them a little bit more with some things they didn't see in the first half.
Let's see if they do just that. And he'll be down deep into New Orleans territory. A big play there, Ryan to Jones, 49 yards. So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. Ryan on the handoff, it's Freeman. And now running right through it. They showed off a nice juke of the defender before the next wave could bring him down. 9 yards is the pickup there, and they'll have a second and one. Freeman again, and he'll be brought down this time at the 5 yard line. They give him 2 yards there as they're set up now with a first and goal.
Now that's the way to do it. Hand it to someone with vision and good footwork and handling a little bit of power, and you find a way to pick up first downs.
Now it's Ryan, and he can't escape the pressure. Ryan goes down.
Well, there's still time to rectify this situation because the silver lining, they took a sack on first and goal. But that close to the goal line, it still definitely hurts.
It's second and goal, back to the 8 yard line now. They get it to him running left. And they're going to get him down, but not before a pretty good run right there. A nice run there, 8 yards, moves him much closer to the goal line now for third down.
Hey, let's go.
Two straight shots on the ground, now on third, do you go to the air?
I think the possibility exists, and if you're doing it, you're probably doing play action.
And he gets in, touchdown Atlanta. It's the fullback taking it in, and the Falcons will add on to their lead. A good, sustained drive there in this third quarter, capping it off with a touchdown to give them a nice two-score advantage.
It was actually a fun one to watch, wasn't it? I mean, for me, seeing the mix of what they did, how they moved the ball downfield, very sharp, too. Each and every play seemed to be executed with great dispatch.
Gets fielded in the end zone. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. Now the attention turns to the Saints offense getting ready for their first possession of the second half. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. Ball on the 30 as they come up second and 10. On second down, Bridgewater again. There he goes, left side. And he takes this one back into the end zone, and the Falcon defense has a touchdown. This D wanting to put it away before we even get to the fourth quarter, widening that margin a bit further.
And while they won't just empty the bench just yet, if you're a backup, start loosening up. I think you'll get a chance to play before this one is over now with that type of a cushion.
Tavecchio good on the extra point. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out, a good one, as he's up a yard or two shy of the 30. And now the Saints get set to trot out there. And they just had that pick six. I guess the only positive maybe of them returning that for a touchdown, this offense right back out onto the field to try to make up for it.
I like that, because now it doesn't give them a chance to go to the bench and really settle, you know, to sit there and kind of seethe over the idea that they turned the ball over previously. Right back out there, it's almost like hopping right back on the bike after falling over. Mm-hmm. See if they can get the ball moving again.
Yeah, we'll see if they can do it here. 6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and four.
Cut.
Now Bridgewater. Over the middle, it's Jared Cook. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue. Now a play fake here on first down. Pressure brought in, and the Falcons get there for the sack. Vic Beasley in there to get him for his second sack of the night.
I think we've seen this before. Someone's down three scores. That situation there, she's going to add to their growing frustrations, don't you think?
Yeah, a bad number three right now. Three-score game, third quarter, three and out, not what they wanted. And you can tell on the sideline, those faces are getting a little bit longer as this one goes. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. They get 11 back on that one. It leads to third down. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. On third down, Bridgewater. He completes it to Bryant. Two catches now in this divisional round matchup. That one, a first down.
Nice catch right there. Brings to mind the sentence, when in doubt, find your veterans.
He used to laugh back in the day when they would call guys like him crafty veterans. You get up in your 30s, you're still playing receiver, but you're around that long at that position, you're doing something right.
Just remember this. When he was young, he thought the crafty veteran was simply a guy who couldn't run anymore. Now he understands a little bit better.
And down inside the 15 he goes. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling. From the red zone now, Bridgewater. And incomplete, he dropped it in the end zone.
After all the preparation, all the practice, a play like that will absolutely break your heart. They had everything they wanted, just unable to complete it. In the end zone, a big time drop.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. To the air again with Bridgewater. Escaping the pressure right. And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. It's Desmond Trufant. And it's a big turnover there on the final play of the quarter. Back now here live in New Orleans. It's the Falcons. They've got the football. They've got the lead as we get set to start the fourth. Bryant will bring the Falcons up now first and 10 at their own 14-yard line. And he's going to lose yardage here back to the 12-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
Well, Brandon Pace comes into play now because they've got the advantage. They've got the football, but they've got to be very careful about what speed they're going to play. You know, my music teacher back in New Paltz, Mrs. Bythema Bagley, used to say, don't go prestissimo when you really want to go largo. And what she meant by that is don't go too fast when you really want to go at a nice, slow, deliberate pace.
I am speechless. I am without speech. A very solid gain of 27.
As a general rule, offensive linemen like to know where their quarterback's going to be when he's setting up to throw the football. But sometimes they just have to get on the run, get on the move. He was able to do that on that play and picks up a first down with a nice throw.
Freeman, and he will be brought down at about the 43 that time. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and 7.
That's it. That's what you want. Straight ahead, positive gain. Just keep that clock ticking.
Off the play fake to Freeman. It's Ryan. And he will find Ridley on the left side. And they're able to work this to the 25 before it's all said and done. A gain of 32 that time. This is something you got to be wary of defensively. I mean, just because they're in the mode of trying to burn some clock doesn't mean they won't pass it. They got good yardage out of that one.
Yeah, and really, when you're looking at it, now they've got a fresh set of downs. Look for second down. If they want to take another shot and try and loosen things up, that'd be the time to do it.
Throw right side, caught by Ridley. And he doesn't quite make it, taking it within an eyelash. Dropped at the 1. That one goes for 24 yards.
Hey, let's go.
These guys are running offense like you drive. The pedal is down. Stomp down. How about that? Back-to-back completions. They are rolling.
So much. And he will take it in for a Falcon touchdown. Devontae Freeman, his second touchdown of the night. And the Falcons will extend their lead. Extra point up and good by Tavecchio. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. Here's Bosher to kick it away. That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The Saints coming out now to take the field. And the interception thrown in the red zone last time. We'll see if they can rebound.
I just have to think the last thing he said as they went back out there was, don't do that again. What do you think?
What do you think?
Yeah, I think that. I think that not only did he say that, but he also told him, let's put it in the end zone that it's supposed to be in, all right? The end zone we're trying to score. I know we're being a little bit facetious here, but the bottom line is take care of the football, and everything else should flow from there.
Quick lesson, never ask for play-by-play. And the Falcons get there. The Falcons get the sack. Down he goes. Tyler Davison in there to drop him the seventh time tonight. He's gone down. Pass protection has been a problem all night long as they come up facing second and a bundle. Out of the gun, Bridgewater. Incomplete, right side to Cook. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. A good pickup there, 18 yards as they get closer for third down.
His position, and he's listed as a tight end, but he certainly doesn't run like one, and that's what we're seeing more and more coming into the league. Those guys who can run, make plays after the catch, and gain that additional yardage.
And using that speed there to turn it into a pretty nice little game. Time for a break. Back to finish it off on EA Sports after this. The Saints on third down. They've only converted once in four tries. This time they face a third and two. Throwing, Bridgewater. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. 3 yards there, good enough to keep the drive moving. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. First down, Bridgewater. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out, incomplete.
Let's face it, perfection is something we all chase, whether it's playing this game or whatever we do. Hard to attain, but that's what they were searching for as that pass goes incomplete.
A second down throw for Bridgewater. And down he goes. The pressure getting to Bridgewater.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
Third and long now after the sack, and we'll see if Bridgewater has a response. Throwing is Bridgewater. He's going to let it fly. And incomplete. He can't hang on. Would have been a nice catch. Instead, it brings up a fourth down. Definitely desperation time. This just looks like, hey, throw it down there. Hope that your guy can make a play.
You want him to make a play, but if not, maybe you get a pass interference call. You know, in the NFL, that's a spot foul. You get all that yardage. That would be a big play.
So possession goes over here on the punt, and the offense will take over with a new set of downs. The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. The drive will start with a carry by Devontae Freeman. And he'll be brought down just shy of the 45. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a second and one.
I know you're trying to wring every yard out of a run, but I think 9 yards there is ideal in this situation.
Yeah, now next couple plays, you only need 1 yard. Keep that clock rolling with a lead here in the fourth.
Yeah, and what you're saying is maybe if it takes you one or two more runs to get the first down, that's extra time, extra plays. Really hurts the team on defense.
And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. Only a gain of a yard, but that's all they needed, as that's going to move the chains. Well, one side moves on, and then, of course, there's the other side, and now they face what they don't want to face, and that's the offseason.
Think about the journey just getting to this game. Preseason, right? The OTAs and mini camps before that. Going through the regular season, fighting and scratching and clawing to make it to the playoffs, and then to get to this game, one game short of a conference championship, they'll have the whole offseason to think about it. Let's see if they use it as motivation.
So that'll just about do it for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to EASports.com. From New Orleans, good night, everybody.